OPT versus STEM OPT employment. So there are several differences between regular OPT, the 12-month period, and the 24-month STEM extension period. And in this video, I'm going to try to go over all of them. So first of all, obviously, in order to be eligible for STEM OPT, you have to have studied and be in a STEM program, and you have to be eligible to apply for STEM extension. If you don't know that you're eligible, if you've never heard of STEM OPT, you should check with your school's international office, with your designated school official, to see if you qualify for STEM OPT, because it's obviously a big advantage. Instead of 12 months, you get an additional 24 months, so a total of 3 years of OPT and practical training and employment authorization in the United States. So let's dive into the differences. So the big differences are the company that you work for on STEM OPT has to be e-verified. It has to be registered with the e-verify program. This is absolutely critical. I've shot a separate video for a case study where a student got into a big trouble because the company she worked for was not registered with e-verify, or actually lost the verification during the OPT period. So again, company has to be e-verified on STEM OPT, not a requirement for regular OPT. In addition, for STEM OPT, you have to fill out the training plan, Form 983, and you have to stick to it. So make sure, you know, you complete that plan, you discuss it with your designated school official, and you make sure that your manager, your supervisor, during your STEM OPT period sticks to it, because at the end of the day, otherwise you may violate your immigration status. So don't underestimate the importance on that Form I-983 training plan on STEM OPT. Again, this is not a requirement for regular OPT. And finally, you have to be compensated on STEM OPT. On regular OPT, that is not a requirement, right? You can volunteer. Technically, unpaid internships are acceptable on regular OPT. That's not the case on STEM OPT. You have to be compensated. And the bottom line is, the government has clarified that alternative types of compensation are allowed. So what this means is, if you're receiving stock options or other equity incentives from the company, those are allowed. However, the compensation, the payment, right, the salary you're receiving has to be commensurate with that which other U.S. workers that are similarly situated as you are receiving. So pay attention to that and make sure that, you know, you don't violate this rule, because it could be costly from an immigration standpoint if you're on STEM OPT. Again, under regular OPT, you're not required to be compensated. And these are the main differences. I hope you found this video helpful.